It's always a great joy to be here as we celebrate Catholic Schools Week. It gives me a chance to thank everyone for the tremendous effort to build circles of disciples, followers of Jesus, because that's what all of us are. We're children of God, made in God's image, called to fall in love with the Lord and give our lives to His service. I thank Dr. Mikrovich and the staff at the school's office at the Diocese. I thank all of the principals and teachers and staff who dedicate themselves so generously to really forming the minds and hearts of our students. I thank our parents and benefactors. I thank our pastors, all the priests and Deacon Martin who are here this morning. And I thank all of you, our students. In 2 years of being here as bishop, I've celebrated many masses in our schools. I prayed with you, shared a lot of visits with you in classrooms, and I've never encountered anything other than absolute respect and attention and reverence and prayerfulness and kindness. And that doesn't happen by accident. So it means that all of us are working really hard to live the life of Jesus. And today we gather to celebrate that great gift. And before I was a priest and I'd be sitting at Mass, I never thought in 1,000 years that the priest could see me, that he even knew I was there. And one of the amazing things I learned when I became a priest and got up on the altar is that when you're up on the altar or you're on the stage, you can literally see every face. So you can see at Mass who's asleep, right? Or who's reading the bulletin? Or who's really tuned in and listening? Or who's picking their nose? Or who's texting, right? You see everything. So when I look at you this morning, I can literally see every face that is here. And I say that not to say that you're under surveillance, but to say that every face represents a life. Because each of us is a unique, unrepeatable miracle. Each one of us has a soul. Each one of us is destined to live forever. And each one of us has a mission and a purpose in this life. And so our face represents us. When we get a driver's license, they don't take a picture of our feet or our hands or the back of our head. They take a picture of our face, because our face is unique to us. It defines us. And so when I look at you, I see the first reading come alive. Here is the body of Christ, each one of us different, each one of us unique, each one of us having our own gifts, but God has placed us exactly where He wants us to be. And together, we form that face of Jesus in the world. And that's the whole mission of Catholic education. I usually don't use props at my homily, but today I brought one. This is a beautiful wood carving. Can anybody guess what this is of? It looks like a piece of cloth. I'll give you a hint. What do you think? What is this? Okay, it's Jesus' face. Talking about faces. Why do you think it's on what looks like a piece of cloth? Can anybody think of when did Jesus' face appear on a cloth? Yes. Okay, when Veronica wiped the face of Jesus, right? So this is Veronica's veil. A friend of mine, whose name is Michael, carved this. And his great ambition in life was to be a really talented woodcarver. And what he found, much to his surprise, is that there was really nobody in the United States that could teach him how to do this. And so he apprenticed to a woodcarver in the Austrian Alps. Can you imagine? So once a month, he flew over to Austria, to this little village, and he spent time learning how to do this. I saw some of his first work. It wasn't that good, because he was just beginning. This is fabulous. And he gave this to me as a gift. For most of the course of the human race, there have not been schools like Bishop Noll or St. Stanislaus or St. Thomas More. So if people wanted to learn how to be an artist or a painter or how to build houses or to be a priest, or to be a teacher. They apprenticed. So they hooked up with somebody that knew how to do it well. So artists taught students how to paint. Priests taught young men how to be priests. And you learn by doing it. You learn by watching it. You absorb this hard-won knowledge that was passed down generation to generation. Jesus did the same thing, when you think about it, with the apostles. So for 3 years, the apostles were apprenticed to Jesus Christ. They traveled with him, they lived with him, they watched his miracles, they listened to his preaching, and they learned how to heal, how to preach, how to love, how to serve. So that when he goes to heaven, they're ready to go into action. And so for 2,000 years, Christian disciples have apprenticed and mentored and taught other disciples. And that's what Catholic schools are all about. So we're here to learn Jesus and to build our lives on the rock of Christ that we heard about in the gospel. So when you build your life on Christ, there's nothing that can shake you because you are rooted in the power and the love and the mercy of the Son of God. And so if you have Jesus at the center of your life, everything else is going to go great. And if you don't have Jesus at the center, everything else can be really fine on the outside. But like a house built on the sand, the second you get tested, or the second somebody pushes, the whole thing is going to fall over because it's not rooted. So we're here in our schools to learn how to pray and to study the scriptures and to celebrate the sacraments and to learn how to be a good person and to put into practice the gospel of Jesus. I would say as a bishop, I have limited ability to influence because I can say all the right things and I can be easily dismissed. You know, of course the bishop is going to say that. He gets paid to say those things. But imagine hearing about Jesus from the lips of a 7-year-old. Imagine watching a 14-year-old so live her faith that everybody else in her life takes notice. Because you are apprentices, as are indeed all of us, but you're already disciples. So it's not too early to put on Christ and to live your life for him and to be a light in the world for others. That's what we're all about in Catholic schools. That's why your parents sacrifice and save to send you here. That's why our teachers and staff dedicate their entire life to doing what they do so well, to form you. So today, as I look at all of you, I see beautiful examples of what it means to fall in love with Jesus and to live totally for him. We live in a world today that's very confusing, sometimes very frightening, very divided, and very filled with conflict. You are coming of age at a time when our country and our world has never needed leaders more. Leaders of faith, leaders of integrity, leaders of goodness and mercy. People who will show us what it means to follow God's teaching. So much will be expected of you as you step into your life and as you grow up. Today, these school years, grade school and high school, you're building your life on the rock of Christ. So don't ever turn away from him. Don't ever give up on your faith. Don't ever stop believing. There's times God can be pretty quiet, right? There's times when I really need an answer from God and I'll pray in front of the Blessed Sacrament and I'll actually say out loud, God, say something. I need an answer to this question. But there's always just silence. But in that silence, there's a presence. And in that presence, there's a word or an inspiration or a thought or an image that comes to my mind and heart. And that's God's answer. Today, as we celebrate Catholic schools, I also want to just give an infomercial for the wonderful gift of Bishop Noll. So for those of you who are in grade school, I would strongly encourage all of you to consider coming here for high school or to one of our other high schools. This Catholic high school is so important to continue building that house of our spiritual life on the rock of Christ. And certainly Mr. Pastrick and the faculty and staff and Mr. Mullaney here at Bishop Noll do their best to create this excellent school. So the more of us that can support it, attend it, participate in it, the stronger our Catholic schools are going to be. And we're going to keep forming disciples for years to come. So I give praise and thanks to God today for the gift of every single one of you and for the ways that you generously live your faith and that you witness Jesus to others. We are the body of Christ built on the rock of Jesus, and we have a mission in this world to bring everyone we meet into that circle of life and light and salvation that is Jesus. For all of that this morning, we give thanks and praise.